Today we are going to be showing you how to integrate your FileMaker database with your Squarespace website. I strongly recommend you just going to our article on our website for this Squarespace integration and getting the demo file, because that has the scripts and everything that would be a great start for you to reference. So what you're going to need to do, first thing is go to your Squarespace website, get into the config mode, go to settings, advanced, and then developer mode. You're going to need to enable developer mode for this to work. With developer mode, that lets you gain access to behind the scenes to the template file, be able to create what we're using, the static pages. When you enable developer mode, however, though, this makes it so that you don't receive updates from Squarespace, and also any pages that you create from FileMaker, you cannot edit using the Squarespace editor. It's all completely controlled by basically you entering in your own HTML and page information from there. It does copy the, you know, include the CSS and everything from the your website, so you don't have to worry too much about the styling. But as far as what content is on there, you can't edit it from the normal config section. You'll also want to copy the information inside of here, your username, password, the host name, and the port. Typically, the host name and the port are going to be what I have here, and then you'll just have to have your own username and password. So once you have that information, you are going to also need to have what your Squarespace subdomain is. So that is, for us, this temporary website that we spun up. It's basically what is before the squarespace.com. So for us, it's this pomegranate gray 874D. So you'll need to have that information as well. And so finally, the last thing that you're going to need is a plugin that can do SFTP. So FileMaker does have the ability to FTP, but it doesn't have the ability to do SFTP, which is secure FTP. So we are using the Base Elements plugin for that, and you can get that from the link inside of our demo file. And you'll just download either the Mac version or the Windows version, whatever you're using, and put that inside of FileMaker. You can put it right inside of the preferences, and then the plugins, there's a reveal your plugin folder. You'll want to restart FileMaker after you put that in, so that way the plugin takes hold. So once you have all that information, you can go into here. So I've already set it up a little bit so that if we look at this demo page that I have, this is all set up from FileMaker. So if I go into here and then I make a little update inside of this, so let's say make a change, and I send that over to Squarespace, and then refresh here, you're going to see now that it has that change. So all that information just came straight from FileMaker. And if we look in the scripting a little bit, what we're doing, there's a couple things that you'll need to do. We're using FileMaker 18 because we're going to need to be able to create a file and pass that file as FTP. So here we're using the data script steps that FileMaker has in FileMaker 18 to create a page file and a config file or conf file. Those are both files that we're going to need. The page file is essentially your HTML that you're going to be, what your website is going to look like. And then the conf file is going to have some information on your page, like what is the title, what is the URL for it, that sort of thing. So that gets pushed over through FTP or SFTP and creates the web page. I'll create a new one just so you can see what it looks like when we create a brand new page. So that one was one I already had, and I was just updating it. When you're creating a brand new page, I'll let this run for a second, and we go back to the website. When you go into the configurator for Squarespace, you want to go to pages for any new page, and it's going to show up under the over here as unlinked. And in order for you to make it linked, you'll have to actually either drag and drop it to something so that it's tied to the page or tied to your website, or you could have another dynamic page that is, you know, like this demo one is already linked to the navigation that then has links to the other pages. So if we were to close this out and go here, one of the things that I had is I entered a link button inside of here that when I click this, it takes me to the demo page that I had. So essentially, if you had multiple pages that were being created from inside of FileMaker, you'd want to have another page that essentially has all the a list of all the pages that you can go to, or however you want your website to work, you can tie a dynamic page to another dynamic page. The one thing that I did want to show, though, is when it is a page created from FileMaker, so if I go to this demo page, I cannot change this text itself. You can update, you know, the above it and below it, but the page that gets created gets inserted essentially into the body of the of your web page. That is static. I can't change it from inside of Squarespace. You have to change it from FileMaker. That is all we have. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us. Thanks.